The last barrier algorithm I'm going to describe to you is what is called the dissemination barrier. And it works by information diffusion in an ordered manner among the set of participating processes. And what you will see is that it is not pairwise communication, as you saw in the tree barriers and the MCS barrier or the tournament barrier, but it is through information diffusion. The other nice thing about this particular barrier, the dissemination barrier, is that it is, since it is based on ordered communication among participating nodes, it's sort of like a well-orchestrated gossip protocol, and therefore n need not be a power of 2. And you will see why this condition need not be satisfied as I start describing the algorithm to you. So what's going to happen is that there's going to be information diffusion that's going to happen among these processes in several different rounds. And in each round, what's going to happen is that a processor is going to send a message to another ordained processor, and the particular processor that it's going to choose to send it is dependent on the round that you're in. So the idea is that processor PI will send a message to processor PI plus 2 to the k mod n. This is the peer to which PI is going to send a message to. And of course, you know, an example is always more illustrative. So since we have 5 processes here, we can then figure out what's going to happen in every round. In round 0, k is going to be 0. So what's going to happen is that since k is 0, round 0, P0 is going to be sending a message to PI plus 2k, k being 0. It's going to send it to P1. So P0 sends a message to P1. Similarly, P1 sends a message to P2. P3 sends P2 to P3 and P3 to P4. And the arrangement is that this is cyclically arranged, that if P4, the neighbor for him, is going to be in the cyclic order, whoever is the next neighbor. So in this case, since it is mod function that we're using, P4 is going to be sending its message to processor P5 mod n, n being 5, it'll be sending the message to P0. So this is round 0 of the communication. So the key thing that I want you to get is that in every round, we're going to see more rounds in a minute, in every round, a processor is sending a message to an ordained processor based on the round number. So depending on the round number, so round number 0, P0 sending to P1, and so on and so forth, and that is what's going on. So this completes one round of gossip. And what you want to see is that all of these communications that I'm showing you are parallel communication. They're not waiting on each other. So P1, whenever it's ready to arrive at a barrier, it is going to tell the next guy. P2 is going to tell the next guy when he's ready, and so on. Now, how will these guys know that round 0 is done? Well, if you take any particular processor, let's say P2, as soon as it gets a message from P1 and it has sent a message to P3, it knows that round 0 is done so far as P2 is concerned. It can progress to the next level or next round of the dissemination. So each of these processes are independently making a decision that the round is over based on two things. One is they've sent a message to the peer, and they've also received a message from the ordained neighbor that they're supposed to get it from. At the end of that, they can move on to the next round.